In this gem session, we'll learn how to create this parametric hedgehog geometry that we're going to drive with some target points, and we're going to use the action sequencer to parametrically control it. So let's start. Let's remove this. I've got a base geometry here in SketchUp. It's basically two arcs, one on plan and one on the side view. And I'm going to just complete this arc with a line. Just draw a line segment here to create a face and use the follow me tool to generate my surface geometry. Now I'm going to select this geometry here and export it to OBJ. In the options, I'm going to try to get quads to see if it goes. It should yield quads, so let's try that. And I'm going to leave it untitled for the, just overwrite whatever I got there. Now let's capture it into gem. So I'm moving to gem, loading a mesh file, pointing to the file I just created in SketchUp, the OBJ file. And I got my base geometry created here. Now, if we look at this geometry, we can just explore it by drawing a face map, clicking here on the plus icon. And we can see the direction of this geometry. What I want to do first is change this geometry. So first I'm going to use rotation. When the face map is displayed, I can use the show button here and then press rotate. It will rotate the arrows, so I get the arrow direction on the horizontal direction. And now I can start working with this geometry. So I'll start by creating an offset. I'm going to start with 1 meter offset. Let's see how that goes. Well, the offset direction is the opposite to what I want, so I'm going to change it to -1. So basically, you can see that I can control the offset direction and magnitude very easily. Now, I want to get it as one of my driving parameters, so I'll start recording the actions of this modeling operation. So let's start. We go to Plugins, we go to Sequencer, and the Sequencer window opens up. When you press the Record button, it basically frees up the geometry, and it actually captures it, so we can roll back to the starting point of our recording session. Now, we're going to start the process again, so I'm going to document the first offset. We'll notice that the offset action is going to be written here in the sequencer. You can see the magnitude here. The next operation will be an echo of the reference grid. So you can see here I can point to reference. I'm using a fixed value and I'm using the echo command from here, phase echo. And now I'm going to set it to, let's say, 0.1, 10%. So it's going to leave 10% of the original size. Now, interestingly enough, you can see that it almost disappears, but what I wanted to create was this kind of pyramid spikes. So I'm going to use a component which is a cube from the library. It's a very simple component to use. And I'm going to use, just to populate it first to see the result. You can see that the normal direction is flipped, so I can press on B both sides on the keyboard. Alternatively, I can flip the normals of my component. Press here, flip normals, and then the result will be working just fine. If you want to change the lighting levels here, we can click on the screen here, press enter to get the command line empty. Type amb for ambient, and we can just make it 40%, and let's visualize that again. So I just created slightly lighter image. Now, what I want to do is I want to introduce the control by shifting the reference faces relative to a target point. So let's start by marking the target points that the shift direction will start measuring from. So let's take, for example, this edge here. And I'm setting it now to variable mode, still working on the reference cloud, which is the red part here, and I'm choosing shift face. Now I'm working based on relative values, so I can set it. It's basically measuring the full size is 1, so I can say we start from 0, no transition, and we measure up, let's say, to 10, 10 times the size of the original face, and we set it to go. The operation is documented as well, and we can now have a look at it. And this is the first alteration. You can see how it shifts towards one side. If you're happy with the result, you can first of all stop the recording and let's populate it to file. Let's call it gem model. This will be our first option, saving it. Now I'm going to create some additional options. So let's, for example, add some points of interest and change some of these proportions. For example, I wanted to have it a little bit flatter, so I can go to rewind the geometry from the action sequencer, and let's start with an offset of minus 0.3 instead of minus 1. The face echo is another parameter we can change, and of course the shift magnitude. Let's play this and see the result. Alright, so now we got the same surface but with much tighter offset, so you can see the result is much tighter to the surface. And we can replay that, just rewind the result, and let's add another target point. For example, let's make another target point here and another one here, and we'll see how it will behave in relative to that. I'm gonna again unweld the geometry and press play here. And now we can see the result. And of course, we can continue to play around with these figures and outputs as much as we want. And of course, generate different alternatives. So we can clear the target points. We can go to targets, clear all, and select a new target. So let's allow everything to spring, let's say, from the center here. And I'm going to set it to run again. So again, I'm rewinding the geometry. Just to be on the safe side, I'm going to unweld it and press play. If you want to be on the safe side, we can just untick this unweld and everything will work fine. So we don't need to unweld manually. Okay, so you can see the results. Let's create this option. We'll call it gem model 1. And use the same one with bigger offset. So let's set it to be, again, 1.5. Roll back. Play the action sequence again. Get the result, you can visualize it, let's save it, this will be gem model 2, and we can then load the results in SketchUp. So let's start with the first one. So I'm importing gem model. This is the first alternative we created. We can select it. Let's just move it slightly to the side of this so we can compare options. Now we can go to import GeoModel 1. This was another option. Again, the target point was changed, altered here. And we can move this one too. So let's take this and this and move them now to the side. And import the last one, GeoModel 2. And we can visualize the results. So the action sequencer actually allows us to control the complex operation that we build and explore various alternatives very fast. And you can see how very simple it is to create this kind of generative parametric control over the component's population.